What's a joke you want to tell us?
A man walks into a bar, the grasshopper on his shoulder. The bartender says, "Hey, you got a drink named after your friend there."
Want to take me out?
No.
Oh, I'm getting rejected?
Where was I?
Did anybody read this play before opening night? Who's heading the play section committee? Osama bin Laden?
Yeah,
he actually brings in.
He actually says that. Yeah.
Just in case some sort of sick curiosity might lead you to make reservations, let's nip that in the bud. Let's nip that in the bud with a plot description. It's 1348, and the Black Death is ravaging Europe. We're in France, and a monk decides to get up a troop of comedians to tour the land and alleviate suffering. And 3 hours later, they all get killed by the Pope. If you promise me Russell Crowe's home phone number, I still wouldn't be able to tell you what the hell Bob's meant.
Oh, jeez. Bullshit.
We switch from dialogues and monologues of deep meaning and profundity to scenes of the troops' comedic antics. The only problem is that, the way Barnes writes, the serious stuff is so bad you laugh, and the comedy is so awful you sit silent and agog. A blind juggler, a comedian with a stutter, two one-legged dancers, a nun.
A nun who wants to be raped, does it say that?
A nun going on about how she'd love to be raped. The laughs simply never stop. I seem to glean somewhere in hour three that maybe Barnes was posing the question, is humor a valid weapon against misery? But since, like, it's never funny, the only question you have is, why didn't the usher...
Never funny. Yeah, I would have said that too.
You need to complete sentences.
It's never funny as in caps. The only question you have is why didn't the usher kick you in the stomach instead of showing you to your seat? Same pain, but with much less time commitment.
That's a great thought.
I kept imagining these students. I kept imagining these students at the first read-through. At Witter with the excitement of a big main stage production, and then fade out, fade in to 3 hours later, and their pale, ashen faces, mute with terror, but all thinking as one, you mean I paid this school to be in this show? And God, how they slog away on stage, line after line, page after page, hour after hour, each joke landing with a louder thud than the one before it. If this cast doesn't exist in mass after the doesn't exit in mass after the last performance and enroll in a computer programming school, there's no hope.
Read that last line again.
All right. Take two.
If this cast doesn't exit en masse after the last performance and enroll in a computer programming school, then there's no hope.
I have a big problem!
Jed Allen Harris directs. I guess he must have lost a bet. Jesus. He throws every single piece of technical gimmickry he possibly can at the script, but it's a losing battle. And Mary Schrader Marcucci has designed the stunning setting with only one flaw. We can still see the play.
Oh! Oh, that's, oh.
Such a jerk!
That is great!
This public reading of reviews?
Yes!
Yeah? Whose review?
Ted's silly.
Did you read it?
No. I saw the show last night, by the way. Great. Great show.
You wouldn't know it.
Oh, is this the Drop Dead one?
No, I've heard it.
If this cast doesn't exit en masse after the last performance and enroll in a computer programming school, then there's no hope. Alan Harris directs. I guess he must have lost a bet. Who's heading the play section committee? Osama bin Laden?
Oh, okay. Well, he's just writing for readers, that's all.
This is for us.
That's rude.
And before any of you put this down as me just being cranky, I would like to point out that over half the audience left at intermission. When I came back after several life-giving cigarettes, the place looked like a bomb had gone off. Which, in a way, it did. In the interest of truth in reporting, I must tell you that there was actually one funny joke in the whole evening. During an audition scene, one of the comics introduces himself this way. I suffered for my art. Now it's your turn. Hey, wait a minute. Maybe it wasn't a joke. Red Noses continues at Carnegie Mellon University through December 8th. We'll be right back.
with you.
What have we just seen?